Hiroshi Tanahashi, Kenta Kobashi, Mitsuhara Misawa, all legends when it comes to the Japanese professional wrestling scene, but there's one that has made an indelible mark on the Japanese wrestling scene more than anyone, and that's the great Sasuke. And I hadn't heard about this, but earlier in the year, there was a documentary that was made about him, and I feel as though it needs to be talked about, so let's get into it. Tokyo, 1996. We are introduced to who exactly the great Sasuke is, along with, holy crap, that's a whole lot of titles that he won throughout the years. Sasuke was and is a hell of an athlete, and in the documentary they state how he was one of the first high flyers in Japan to make a name for himself. Working a sellout crowd almost every night, the great Sasuke became one of the most popular wrestlers in Japan with his crazy, larger-than-life acrobatics. And at one point, he was so good that he held 9 titles at one time. Now that's fucking insane. The great Sasuke got into the world of professional wrestling when he says that one day, he heard the voice of God telling him that he needed to become a professional wrestler. He maintained a hell of a career, but after years of wrestling greatness and doing insane things with his body, Sasuke knew when to give up his spot. And although he still wrestles in the documentary and out of it, he no longer wrestles in the main event spot, but he wrestles in either the mid-card or the opening card act, and working preferably smaller shows. Something that I thought was unique is the fact that Sasuke, he even wears his mask in his normal day-to-day life. I thought at first he was wearing his mask so that the documentary crew didn't see his face, but he goes around his daily life wearing that mask. Which I thought was really weird, but unique in a sense of him trying to keep some sort of kayfabe, I guess. And we also get to meet Sasuke's wife along with his 2 kids, and they talk about how it is living with a real-life wrestling legend. We then jump to the story of how, while on a tour in Mexico, Sasuke saw how the people over there loved and admired the sport of professional wrestling on a whole other level, that he was once again struck by the voice of God. But this time, God was telling him that he needed to wrestle in Japan to make wrestling great in his hometown. So Sasuke decided the best way for him to do that is to start his own promotion, Michinoku Pro Wrestling, with the sole goal of bringing Mexico's Lucha Libre high-flying style that captivated the nation over to Japan. And Sasuke basically started the Japanese independent wrestling scene, as wrestling at the time was only made available in the larger cities of Japan, and now wrestling was being exposed in the local areas all over the country. Wrestling, taking care of his family, and running a promotion which could be a lot for some other wrestler, but we're talking about the great Sasuke here, and this was just a tiny little piece of what he wanted. So he decided that he was going to become an assembly legislator in 2003, becoming the first masked politician, beating Kane to the punch a whole 15 years. However, it wasn't all good times for Sasuke, as at the same time, one of Sasuke's advisors showed their financial statements of Michinoku Pro Wrestling to some friends to ask how they were doing, and well, they said, to put it bluntly, you're fucked. And not too long after, Sasuke would eventually find himself in debt due to the low amount of people that were showing up to Michinoku Pro Wrestling shows. Sasuke would try to forget about his problems in the wrestling world by running for the gubernatorial election in 2007, and there was a lot of support for Sasuke at the time, and it certainly helps when you're one of the most popular wrestlers of all time. But at the same time, he hadn't done a whole lot in the politics game, so naturally people didn't think it would be such a good idea for him to hold office, which of course led him to losing the election. The mounting pressure of his company possibly going under, along with his failed election, not to mention the family that he needed to provide for, would prove to be too much for Sasuke, and he would find himself getting arrested after a fan took a picture of him on the subway, and that was just the breaking point for Sasuke as he attacked the man and would be arrested. Sasuke had reached an all-time low after one too many losses. At this point in the documentary, it cuts to present day, and one of the aspects that I like about the documentary is that it shows how hard it really is to run a wrestling company. You see Sasuke as he struggles to sell tickets for his shows, along with other various troubles that he has trying to keep his company afloat, and that not every wrestling promotion can be successful like AEW or WWE. We also see Sasuke, he's still wrestling, even though he's been in the business for over 20 years at this point in the documentary. He was also 41 when this was being filmed, and he's still in relatively good shape. And even though he's 41, he's still doing the same high-flying moves that made him famous years ago during his 20th anniversary match. But at his age, of course, there are bound to be complications as we see the cost and toll it takes on his body. In April 2011, a month after the Tohoku earthquake and tsunami, Sasuke not only helped people by bringing food to the local evacuation centers, but he also is convinced to rerun for prefectural assembly to help the community affected by this natural disaster. But Sasuke takes a big risk as he runs as an independent candidate without any sort of support or financial backing. It's here that the main problem with Sasuke running is addressed, and it's the fact that Sasuke had only previously held office once in his whole entire life, and people were mainly looking for candidates who are more involved with the problems of the community, as well as having more experience. They interview several people about him running, and while some show support, there are others that feel as though he shouldn't be running at all. During this whole entire election, we just see how humble the man really is, even going out of his way by wishing one of his opponents good luck in the race, and he seems to be nothing but genuine in his actions. Sasuke seems like a nice person who only wants to try and help his community, but just like any person, he is flawed and ultimately loses the election. And it's a little sad to see, just because throughout the entirety of his run, we see how passionate the man really is about running, and all he was trying to do was give back to his community, and you could tell that he was really just giving his all. Despite his loss, Sasuke still finds time to give back to people who had been affected by natural disasters, even throwing a wrestling show for children at schools who had been affected by said disasters as a way to escape reality. Sasuke had this philosophy, and he still does, that pro wrestling can be used for more than just wrestling, but as a way of escapism and something that can be used for good. They throw the show, the kids love it, and the documentary ends with Sasuke still wrestling and still having the same passion for the business that made him a huge star over 20 years ago. The documentary itself is actually quite good, and it shows the highs and lows of the living legend known as the Great Sasuke, and how great he really is, not only as a professional wrestler, but as a human being. Despite the adversity that he faced, Sasuke still finds time not only to wrestle, as he was involved in Jushin Thunder Liger's final match this year at Wrestle Kingdom 14, but he still gives back to his community wherever he can, just to show how kind of a person that he really is. You can find this documentary here on YouTube if you are curious about checking it out. I'll leave a link in the description if you guys really want to check it out. And it leaves us with the message that when it comes to Sasuke, he will always be considered great amongst his fans.